everyone, I am Amit Danai, the chief editor and founder of ANI Digest. Welcome back to the third episode of the series ANI Digest Mighty Minds. The topic of the first two parts was cinema and design, where you heard the thoughts and views and the candid interviews of two brilliant groups of architects and interior designers. In this third episode, titled Introspection, you will be delving into the minds of successful architects and interior designers following their journeys. All of them have been practicing for more than 20 years. In fact, many of them have been practicing for more than 25 years and are very successful as architects and interior designers. So let us enjoy this episode and go into their journeys of how they mapped their careers in design. We have with us in this episode architects Vinod Dusia, Manish Shah, Ashish Sachde, Atul Diwane, Vikas Shevare, Vipin Bora, and interior designers Milind Chingre, Sandeep Gokhale, Nilesh Makwana, and Abhijit Raizoni. I've been tracking the careers of all these architects and interior designers since the inception of ANI Digest for almost 25 years. So let us hear their thoughts, views, their candid sharing of their strengths and weaknesses, the do's and don'ts which they followed during their career. Happy weaving. Very good evening, friends. Thank you so much for accepting our invitation and being on the ANI Digest Mighty Minds. We'll start with Vinod. We'll start this episode with Vinod. Good evening, sir. Vinod, what are your learnings from the recent past, from your ups and downs in the recent past, say last 4 years?
See, I have observed one thing. Any kind of profession, I mean, whether it is ours or in, there's a cycle of around 4 to 5 years for ups and downs. Sometimes the market is good, sometimes it is not. But that cycle comes after 4 to 5 years. This is what I feel. Yes, we need to be prepared for the for such kind of situations. But at the same time, your moral needs to be intact. So what we try to do, at times, sometimes the projects are not there. The slowdown in the project, sometimes there is a slowdown in the market, sometimes there is a slowdown in the amount of funds which is flowing in. But as an architect, I mean, the morale, the interest, the fun which you get from the work, I think we keep that on. Whether the market fluctuates from here to there, it doesn't matter to us. Because at times, the amount of money which is coming, whether less or more. But when you take, there might be a bigger job, you know, but the amount of money is also more. But at times, as architects and designers, even if we do a small detail, even if you do a small design, we feel very happy about. And that is where I feel ki we cherish and take the fun of that rather than focusing on the market.
So your learnings are?
My learnings are ki focusing on your work, focusing on the enjoyment which you get in the regular practice is more important than the fluctuation of market in terms of money and the amount of jobs. This is what I feel.
Excellent, excellent. Ashish, the same question goes to you.
Yeah, I feel like when we are in a profession, metaphorically you can compare it to a war. You know, कहाँ से गोली आने वाली है, कहाँ से नहीं आने वाली है, क्या होने वाला है कुछ नहीं पता. ठीक है, so you always have to be on your toes every time, and you know, never depend on one area of your practice. You know, have a multidisciplinary practice, like, you know, you are handling residential, commercial, developer segment. So kuch na kuch kabhi na kabhi chalta hi hai. Okay, so as far as my own practice is concerned, we do a lot of things which are, you know, diabolically opposite. So we handle developers, we handle small flats, we handle villas, we handle commercials. So by God's grace, those cyclical moments have not disturbed us yet. So I think it is a diverse practice.
Vikas?
Ups and downs is a part of our life. I would say we have to accept this as a professional person. So we have to work it out, what is our up area, where we have a lot of projects as an architect, what you say, and where there is a time we don't have the project. That time we have to learn from our mistakes. or we have to prove yourself, okay, fine, this sector is good, we have to focus more in that. That is what I wanted to always, you know, give a thought for me, myself, when as an architect, you have to adopt all this situation. Any, like, you know, when you have a good time, you have to adopt that. When you have a bad time, you have to adopt that. Yeah.
Nilesh?
Hi. Regarding this impression, okay, the same thing I feel we need to intercept what's going wrong in that phase or particular project. Try and analyze the mistakes that we have done and try to improve on it and don't repeat the mistakes again and be motivated to do best the other time.
So introspection is important, self-analysis is important.
Very true.
And not to repeat mistakes.
Yeah, definitely.
Oh, very nice. Atul?
I feel there are always various highs and lows, you know. When there are highs, we have to remind ourselves there are always going to be some lows, sometime. That are going to creep in. And when there are lows, you remind yourself that this is not going to get any worse than this. So that is the time when you really pump yourself up and shoot up.
Great. Vipin?
I have always learned from my work. Each project of me or us has a lesson. In the recent time, what I learned is that technology can add a great value to your work. Something novel, advanced, is always admired and appreciated.
Abhijit?
See, according to me, we should keep ourselves updated. And as compared to the ups and downs, from downs, personally me, I have learned what mistakes I have done. And for the ups, I have learned that how to overcome those mistakes. So that's all.
Manish?
Well, instead of the 4 years, I'd like to talk about last 6 months, the current pandemic situation. It's very challenging for everyone. And in last 6 months, I realized that life is uncertain, unpredictable. You cannot predict about the future. So enjoy each and every moment of your life in your own way. That's all. Ups and downs are always there. You have to come through it. That's all.
Excellent. Sandeep?
See, I would agree with Nilesh actually for that. Ups and downs are a parcel of our life. Everybody's life for that. Nobody's spared. Yeah, but recently it happened. Sometimes everything is going fine. Like my sites are going fine, my openings are good, my client is satisfied. But somewhere, what he said, I agree to him that you need to introspect yourself. So this ups and downs don't matter a lot. So 3 years back, we felt like everything was very nice. 10 sites were going on. It was very nice. The client was also satisfied. But somewhere we felt that something is going on. Something was missing. We were really bored. I was not satisfied actually.
So you are not creatively challenged enough.
Then eventually we sat down for that. We took time out of it. And we realized that we are repeating ourselves too much. The concepts have been repeated. So cautiously we tried to avoid that. And we learned it.
Excellent. So in the past 4 years, you learned that you all were repeating. And that's why it was not creatively.
And we learned that we should be continuously different. That is what I learned.
Excellent. Milind?
Yeah. If you are doing this various kind of projects as a commercial, residential or kind of project, so I don't feel this you will get particularly stagnant or something. Just keep going, just like that.
Okay, so like Ashish said, that our diverse portfolio,
100%,
keeps you on the toes, and
you never find this. No, it's a slack hai, kuch hai.
So this is what is your learning from the last 4 years, ups and downs. Okay. The second question, we will go to Nilesh. Nilesh, which is the hardest skill which you had to acquire during your career, to apart from your design skills, to succeed in your profession?
Okay. Let me be very frank. Initially, I was not a very social person, right? So biggest learning I had to do was to be social, to interact with people, I was not that initially, but I learned that. I learned to be a good listener, okay? And nowadays, I feel it's very important to market ourselves. That is very important. No matter how good designer you are, but if you can't market yourself, it's not going to help. So I learned that. And to be on lighter side, shifting from the drafting boards to the AutoCAD was difficult. So we have to be updated to all new technologies like the AutoCAD, now the 3D Max, and you need to be updated with that.
So instead of one, there were two hard skills, equally hard.
You have
marketing
to,
yourself.
Yeah, marketing and, was the toughest, like, yeah.
Or, and learning softwares.
Correct. Okay. You
need to. Atul?
The hardest was presenting your designs, presenting yourself. This is something that I also learned during my internship. Whatever you design, whatever you do, it only matters how you present it. You know, it could be the best design that you do, but if you can't present it well, you've lost it. So, and it could be the worst, it could be the other way also. It could be the worst design that you've ever done, but you present it well and it just carries off.
So presentation skills.
So presentation does matter. That is something that I've really learned.
So you feel every architect or designer should equip himself or herself.
Definitely.
With presentation.
Definitely.
Skills. Vinod?
There is, as a designer, we have some skills which are like inbuilt in us. And we try to stick it to that kind of skills. And at times we become stubborn to that, you know. So adapting to the situations, adapting to the kind of project, adapting to the kind of clients you get, I think that was not there in me. So that is the hardest thing which I actually overcome, and I tried ki, yes, you are designing for others, not for yourself. So you need to change yourself, and that is something very hard for every creative field where, as house, I mean, it's not a painting which we hung to a wall or a kind of media or anything, but something which somebody is going to use. So you need to change yourself. That was very hard for me to change. And that is where I scored. I'm working on it. And,
but just a thought,
yeah,
that an artist also signs his painting, you know, once he creates. Mm-hmm. Though it is created, it is commissioned by a client and he does it for that client, but its sign is there. Do you believe that a designer is allowed to leave his or her signature?
Of course it is. Of course he has to. But he cannot just dominate the way he wants. Because if somebody wants to eat Chinese, he cannot give Punjabi to him. And he's happy with the Chinese itself. So that is what is more important. I mean, we are designing for the users, for his money, for his peace of mind, for his life. I don't think we should design the way we want. Yes, we should educate him. We should try and put up our ideas in front of him. We need to be a signature. This is what Vinod Dusia is. Yes, of course. But how we have modulated to his requirement is also important, which very few people go by it. In our profession, it does matter in terms of ego and attitude.
Absolutely. Well spoken,
yeah.
Vinod.
Yeah.
Ashish, the same question goes to you.
Yeah. Actually, I will not talk about design since it's a non-design question. The hardest thing for me to learn is to when to shut up. When to stop talking, when not to give immediate reactions to anything that comes along, be it profession or be it relationships. ठीक है यार थोड़ा time लेते हैं सोचते हैं हर चीज के ऊपर immediately जवाब देना जरूरी नहीं होता है बोलने वाला भी बाद में सोचता है और हम भी बाद में सोचते हैं यार ये बोला नहीं होता तो अच्छा होता
so it's advantageous
absolutely to... absolutely it's always better to be poised I was not like that before. You know, I just passed out. कुछ भी बोला immediately जवाब दे दिया. बाद में सोचते बैठेंगे यार सही दिया गलत दिया. उसमें many a time it used to happen that there could be an improvised version of putting things across to the clients. You know. And second thing I learned, which is again a non-design specific things, is to completely get into client's shoes and think about it. When we talk about architects, as Vinod rightly pointed, that कुछ दिमाग में अपने fix है कि ऐसा होना चाहिए वैसा होना चाहिए. The moment client starts briefing you, the moment you see the site, The moment you only hear a call कि मेरा 4,000 square foot का plot है, you immediately start designing कैसा बनेगा, क्या बनेगा. With all that prepared mind, you go to the client's meeting, and he starts, you know, telling you this, 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 which may contradict with you, okay? The thoughts that you have in your mind. Just let it sink in. Give some time, couple of days, couple of weeks more, and then respond. Immediate response करना जरूरी नहीं है, ये मैंने सीखा.
Interesting, interesting, very interesting. Vikas?
As an architect, it's a journey. It's from design to conversion. It's a journey, okay? Some clients comes to us and give us some requirements, some thoughts. And there are the clients, they are expecting very fast, in a day or 2 day they want it, but they don't understand the architect mentality. We required some time to think about it, okay? But definitely, he's a client, he's gonna pay us, and we are in a service industry, so his expectation is also there. Definitely we have to achieve some time, sometimes we cannot. That time, we need to understand our patience level. That patience level is very important when somebody gives us some projects.
Manish?
I guess to run your professional practice, you need a lot of skills, different skills. The hardest skill which I found was managing people, be it client or labor on site. You should be able to convince your client about your design ideology, and that's the hardest skill which I had to acquire.
But you believe that in the colleges now, this should be included in the curriculum?
Yeah, certainly, certainly. It's very important aspect.
Okay.
I beg to differ on a few points that some of my colleagues said just now. Regarding clients, rather than accepting bowing down to what they are saying, I think it is the architect's or the interior designer's duty to guide him to the right channel, rather than just accepting, just to convert that project. I accept whatever he has to say, and I say that, okay, it is you who are going to live here, and I'm going to design as per your wishes. That's not going to happen.
Okay.
What I feel is I need to convince this client. Probably to convert that, you probably accept one or two things, and then, put your thoughts across in the right manner, in such a way that the client understands and accepts what you want to say.
Yeah. Sorry. I would like to add on this, Atul. What my consideration was, whatever we design, that we have to explain our client, and that project we have to convert into our project. That was my intention. We are not following any client aspects.
Right, right.
Our design we have to convert into our project.
I agree to that. Accept that.
In a way,
pointed
both
out.
Of you all are making the same point in this thing, that fundamentally we should be right. What is good for the client, this you know better. But at
right.
the same time, the aesthetics or the requirements of the clients have to be considered. That's what Vinod started with. So, very interesting observation on this point. Abhijit, same question.
Hardest skill for me to accept was the truth. See, we design for the client, but it's the client who is going to end use it. So, just for the sake of my site should look good, we shouldn't implement that. We should also take care what the client actually needs. So, according to me, in some years, I have learned that we should accept the truth that the client is the end user, and we should design it according to the client's need, not just for the aesthetics or to emphasize our design on it.
Marketing skills are definitely something to learn about. Don't rely on your mouth publicity of your projects, or don't rely on past laurels.
Koi bhi client agar aata hai, to wo mera achha dost ho jata hai. Aur phir baad mein, wo client nahi rehta hai. Wo client और मैं आर्किटेक्ट नहीं रहता हूँ, हम लोग दोस्त रहते हैं, तो मैं जो भी बोलता हूँ वो सुनता है, और वो जो भी बोलता है वो मैं सुनता हूँ.
Excellent. So making friends with the clients is your the hardest skill which you learned.
Yeah.
Same question goes to you, Milind.
What Vipin says is perfectly. Just because if you made a client as a friend, so I don't think client will ask so many questions or regarding the designing all, the confidence they get.
Ashish, I would like to ask you.
which is that one most important rule, the golden rule, which you never break in your professional practice?
It's ethics and morality.
Practicing as an architect, discipline is very important when we are doing any kind of design or any kind of project.
Well, the golden rule I follow is, unless and until I am satisfied with the design which I have produced or which I have worked on, I don't present it to the client.
We don't repeat our designs, as Sandeep said, and we don't copy designs.
The biggest thing is trust. Because the client gives you this project and he has a trust on you.
I again wanted to come in. See, I said ethics and morality, not just for me only. See, whenever you have 8 to 10 designers working under you who are juniors and they look up to you as their mentor, as their boss or something like that, you know, you'll be surprised to know that they discuss all these things in staff room. अपना बॉस क्या कर रहा है, यू नो, व्हाट एथिक्स डज ही फॉलो, डज ही टॉक द, आई मीन डज ही वॉक द टॉक, यू नो, इट्स लाइक दैट. एंड दे आर गेटिंग, देयर माइंड्स आर गेटिंग शेप्ड डिपेंडिंग अपॉन व्हाट आई एम इन माय ऑफिस, एंड दैट मीन्स अ लॉट टू देयर फ्यूचर. सो इट्स नॉट अबाउट ओनली योर सेल्फ. सी, एनी आर्किटेक्ट विद अ मिड साइज प्रैक्टिस लाइक मी विल हैव a designer working for me for, let's say, 4 to 5 years, 6 years, maybe 3 years, and then he starts his own practice. So it is very important for him to learn the importance of ethics and morale in his practice, so that, you know, he's always confident about himself and he can sleep a peaceful life.
When it comes to work, when you're working at your board, when you're working at your office, I see to it that the output which goes is given the best of the effort from the entire team, me and the entire office. I don't get shaken by anybody who tells me to repeat a design 10 times, 50 times. In the first day when a client meets me, I tell them, till you're satisfied, till you get the right product, till I am satisfied that this is the right product for you, I will not stop. I'll keep on working. It has happened a lot of times when the entire design is done, the working drawings, I think everyone accepts that the working drawing is done, the central line is done, it's digging is happening on site, but the design changes because of the market situation, because of XYZ reasons. But our energy should not go down. I tell my entire office, energy should not go down. Kyun repeat mil raha hai, kyun change ho raha hai. That's the golden thing which I follow to all my staff. Never give up.
There is one practical golden rule that we follow, or I follow in my office, and that is regarding site visits. That is something that I myself get done and encourage the rest of my staff also to do, because I have burnt my hands. Being lazy at times, you know, not doing the right thing, not going for site visits and things like that. So that is one golden rule, you know, patthar ki lakeer jaisa kehte hain na hum log. Okay, that is one thing that we follow, especially when you start a project with your excavation and your center lines. That's the most important thing that you need to do, because once you make some mistake over there, these things multiply later on. And that is something that we really see to it. Site visits are something that you really don't miss out on.
Sir, I have a different opinion for this. See, you might be doing 10 projects, you do 50, you may do 100. You cannot reach everywhere. So, at times what happens is ki, yes, we are passionate and it's the right thing that we need to visit the thing. If your drawings are right, if your designs are right, if your drawings are right till the last detailing, you need not visit the site, because it becomes a habit of the client that trying to extracting your visits, which is not required also, because it becomes habit. So it is always better. As you said, ki clients, there are a lot of clients who say ki humne kaam diya lekin the architect is not, it's not necessary. If the drawings are right, you need not visit. I have done some sites where for the interior I do only 3 visits. When we go and meet the client, then we deliver the drawing, see the kacha dhacha, whatever has been done, and directly the opening. So it's not necessary that we visit for every Tom, Dick things happening on the site. Because it becomes a habit. I mean, that's how I
look at it. Atul, would you like to counter? Is there any other aspect to what he is saying? Which we are not seeing in this?
No. What he's saying is absolutely right. But it is only regarding these particular visits that I'm talking of. You know, even these 3 site visits that he's talking of, people at times take them for granted and, you know, leave them to their associates, leave them to their junior staff. And that is where the mistakes happen. Or probably employ the right person to do this. It's well taken care of. I agree to that. But architecturally speaking, interiors probably at times it may not be required. But architecturally speaking, what I'm talking of is the plinth checking and things like that, you know, where they are essential. You have to see to it that you get it done. And that is what I'm talking of. That is the golden rule that we follow. These visits have to happen, come what may.
Excellent. Yeah, Abhi, you wanted to come in?
I just want to add one more thing. As far as my practice for interiors, I personally think that site visits are must. And not all drawings can serve the purpose as far as my practice in interior is there. And I personally love to go on site because I love to see the changes, what happens every time I go.
Right. How do you handle pressure at work? A. And B, when you reach home, do you mentally cut off from work or work still goes on in your mind even at home?
The counter question you asked, pressure, I think it's the other way around. Pressure is managing us. So pressure should be there. It works as a catalyst, definitely. So pressures are there. They are always going to be there. But yeah, fine. And the most toll which is taken by pressure is on the designing part. So we try and keep it at the bay. And when designing comes, we never compromise. We always do justice with the design. Yeah, but pressure is there. But with experimentation and with experience also, you understand to handle pressure, you know.
Okay. And when you go home, do you cut off from work mentally or it goes on in your mind?
It's absolute no. I don't know if it is bad or good, but yeah, we do carry our work.
Okay.
Because what happens, Amit, daytimes there are a lot of site visits, selection part, and a lot of things are going, a lot of activities are going. You have to handle the staff, you have to sit with them for design. But night is a time when you are really at peace of mind, it's calm, and I love to work at nights.
Okay.
So
you don't mind?
Very comfortable with it.
Okay. Same question to you, Vikas.
Meditation is very important factor of my life to handling this pressure. Okay, so as a Concur Studio, we have compulsion for this 15 minutes meditation compulsory daily for each and every staff. That I realize that any kind of pressure, when you are a balance yourself, you can handle anything. That helps me a lot. As well as I tell my all employees to use this opportunity as a meditator, or you know, we call some person for, you know, give them some good thought about meditation or some, you know, activity we run in a week time, so they follow that activity.
So personally, this is what helps you to handle pressure.
I feel I'm calm to handle that situation, whatever it is, the things, because there are a lot of pressures on site and off site, on in studio. There are the projects we have to, you know, give them in 45 days. Right. That pressure we have to handle. Sometimes it's like very, very difficult to handle. But, you know, when I feel that, okay, I'm a calm, I'm a owner of the company. So I have to be balanced and I have to handle that situation. So meditation is, feel that, okay,
I'm not saying it to 100%, I'm getting it from meditation, but you know, I feel that I'm calm in that way, and I can handle that situation particularly.
And do you cut off from work mentally when you reach home, or work still goes on in your mind?
It's a mixed answer, I would say. Sometimes I cut off my professional life and the personal life, but sometimes yes, because there are a lot of pressure, a lot of project handlings are there. So sometimes I take it professional life at my home, sometimes it's happened, but I have to balance that. It is everybody's, like, you know, agree with me, because we are in service industry. Anybody can call you anytime and you have to answerable for that. So okay. That is what I feel that.
Milind, the same question to you.
After doing so many years, there's a practice of so many years, I never feel that, I never take the pressure of this work. Because for each, every project have a dedicated person for that. So I never think, or never think about that project or something. This project is going on.
Actually, I have a different take on this. Pressure nahi hai na to pressure aata hai. Yeah. Pressure nahi hai to pressure aata hai. Pressure nahi hai to you become lethargic. There has to be a pressure. See, more than 50% of the project that we have done in the past are time-bound projects. Okay. And if a client asks me, घर बनाना है तो उल्टा मैं उसको पूछता हूँ एक साल में हो सकता है आठ महीने में करे क्या. सो इट्स लाइक गेटिंग ओवर विथ इन अ लेसर अमाउंट ऑफ टाइम टिल द आइडियाज आर यंग, यू नो. बहुत बार दो दो तीन तीन साल अगर प्रोजेक्ट चलता है तो आइडियाज देख देख के वो एंगेजमेंट के बाद में कोर्टशिप पीरियड अगर चार पाँच साल का हो जाए तो क्या होगा मालूम है ना.
बट इज इट अनहेल्दी टू लिव इन सच काइंड ऑफ प्रेशर और इट्स पॉजिटिव प्रेशर?
नो इट्स गुड, बिकॉज आई विल टेल यू वन थिंग. There is one subjective part of it and there are objective part of it. What is subjective? Subjective is a design. ये कितना और अच्छा हो सकता था ये हमें नहीं मालूम, या ये कितना बुरा और हो सकता था ये हमें नहीं मालूम. इट्स सब्जेक्टिव. मुझे ये अच्छा लग रहा है, किसी को नहीं अच्छा लगेगा. सब्जेक्टिव. नाउ लेट्स कम टू ऑब्जेक्टिव पार्ट, विच इज अगेन पार्टी टू प्रेशर, इज बजट एंड टाइम. ये बजट में काम खत्म करना है इज अ प्रेशर एंड अ कमिटमेंट, और ये टाइम के अंदर खत्म करना है इज अगेन अ ह्यूज कमिटमेंट. सो इसलिए मैं बोला हूं कि प्रेशर नहीं है तो प्रेशर आता है, और ऐसा होना चाहिए.
बट डू यू कट ऑफ फ्रॉम वर्क व्हेन यू रीच होम, और वर्क गोज ऑन इन योर माइंड इवन एट होम?
या 24/7. द रीजन बिहाइंड, माय वाइफ इज अ डिजाइनर, एंड टू ऐड टू दैट my both kids are pursuing architecture. so
would you give the same advice to your children to create pressure on themselves?
See, I'll tell you one thing, there's a different way I perceive these things. What is pressure and what is not pressure? Pressure is normally termed as something which no one enjoys. Okay, what if I enjoy pressure? What if I am at my bliss when I am pressurized? Okay, I enjoy pressure. Yesterday only we delivered a site which was like constructing a building, doing the interiors of sample flat with no imported furniture used, doing everything on site in 28 days. So building, interiors and everything. Such projects we have completed within 10-15 days also. So I enjoy this.
That's commendable. That's really commendable.
Yeah, thank you.
Vinod?
I agree to Milind. What he's saying is, what is pressure? Pressure is like when things don't go the way you want. It's pressure. When you're not able to manage things, it is pressure. So by experience, you need to formulate things that you don't get pressure at all. You might do 10 jobs today, tomorrow you might do 50 jobs. 10 jobs mein aapko pressure le rahe hain, to 50 jobs mein kya hoga? So you need to formulate things that you don't take pressure even at 50 and 100 also. 10 staff, 100 staffs, whatever. So that's how, the way you manage things is, again, if you take pressure, you cannot think. So it's better we don't take pressure. Let the staff. I mean, we have music in our office. I have music in my cabin. We have a very anytime you can take off. You have a very different kind of an atmosphere in our office. There is no pressure to the kids also in the office.
So you rely on your skill of delegation and management.
Yes, of course.
Plus your subordinates.
Yes, if you take pressure, you cannot design. Only one thing can remain in your mind. One is either pressure or design or creativity. So when you avoid pressure, you take things in fun. I mean, when you manage things go well. Yes, as Vikas said, meditation, I do meditate. A lot of other people also, I tell them, you need to keep calm. When a client is angry on you, at times things are there. I tell them, sir, aap 2 minutes hold kijiye. After 2 minutes again, I call them.
Actually
I do that. Kya hua? Oh, he's saying, Vinod, pura design change ho gaya, aisa ho gaya, waisa ho gaya. Oh, everything is done and he's saying, so kya kiya aapne 2 minutes? Well, sir, maine meditate kiya. So that I don't yell at you. So he starts laughing. So making things lighter, I mean, so since we are designers, I think we need to handle things in a very sensitive fashion. Pressure, like things are getting more pressurized, your minds are getting pressurized, I leave the job.
Oh, so
it's fine. Char kaam kam rahenge, har dane pe likha hai khane wale ka naam. It's fine. Maybe that job is not meant for you. So I try keeping avoiding such things which it's not fit for you. And even the client is happy and I'm also happy.
Very unique input you've given. Abhijit?
Yeah. I'll begin with a quote. Time is the biggest healer. There are pressures on site, but give time. Don't take immediate actions on it. First, understand what are the problems. Take time. There is nothing in the world which is impossible. Everything is possible. So, take time and make a proper decision. That's all I'll
say. So you believe in what he had replied to the earlier question, that don't immediately respond, sleep over it.
Yes.
It will heal and then pressure will reduce. Hmm. Excellent. Very nice. Manish?
When you are handling your own practice, you have to deal with many issues and it's obviously pressure sometimes. As Vikas said, he deals with pressure with meditation. I deal with pressure by following my hobbies, my passion. I do a lot of photography. I do bike riding. I listen to music. If I am going out of Pune for a site visit, I enjoy music. I enjoy my drive. And I may stop at many locations and click just photographs. That's all. And it keeps me pressure free all the time.
But at home, do you cut off from work mentally, or work still goes on once you reach home also daily?
Well, sometimes it happens that I take the work with me in my mind home. It happens if I'm working on an interesting project, if I'm designing something. It happens that those thoughts are lingering in my mind. If I am watching TV, I watch through the TV and I keep on designing something. It happens, but sometimes, not all the time.
Atul, you came in with an interesting counter, but I would like to hear your opinion on this.
Well, pressure is not an on-off switch. I think everybody carries their pressures home. It's about dealing with pressure that is important. Like Vikas said, he deals with pressure by meditation. It is something that probably I also should take up now. Should probably help with your pressures. Okay. But I think pressure is, dealing with pressure, I think, is mainly breaking down your problems into steps of dealing with it. And then dealing with them one step at a time. And that is how you overcome your pressure. So that's basically the answer to dealing with your pressures. So you may carry it home, it may work out, you discuss things with your spouse, probably she or he has a better solution to it, and you come up with a better solution.
But does it work for you this way?
It does.
Vipin?
I take great care of health, physically and mentally.
it keeps me energies high. And while I'm at home, definitely completely I'm at home.
I think pressure will come if you have to do something that you don't know. That is pressure, okay? Now I'm doing something that I'm passionate about. I'm doing since long years. So I have experience in it. In case pressure comes, I think you have to step down from the pressure drama and stay positive. That's how.
I avoid taking it home.
And you are successful in it.
And I'm successful. For whatever years I'm married, kids are there. They've never seen me with a laptop doing some sketching at home.
So you switch off your phone when you reach home?
No. I switch on my phone. It's on always. But
you're selective.
Whose phones to take. And architects might carry home the book and they might be on laptop or a sketching or anything. I don't have a single pencil or a paper of my own in my house. I must have sketched. So I ask a pencil and a pen from my kids and then I do it. But otherwise, I never carry anything home.
And
yes, as everybody said, ki they carry it mentally. Yes, I do carry it mentally. You're walking, you're eating, you're looking at the TV, you're in the bathroom, whatever. The things, the mind never stops. It keeps on thinking. And a lot of designs happen. Even in the lockdown, I didn't had a laptop and nothing. And I was just thinking and I used to handle everything on phone. And we were able to do back 2-3 good big projects. And I don't think you need to carry it home and show it we are working.
As far as me carrying the pressure at home, I didn't answer it. I would love to answer it. There are two types of pressures, a positive pressure and a negative pressure. We do carry both the pressures at home. The negative pressure sometimes reflects on my face and my spouse immediately catches me up. But positive pressures are when you're going to design something new and when you are left it half the way in your office, that comes in back of the mind while I'm sleeping also, in my dreams also it comes.
Any funny client requirements in your career or funny client briefs or any funny incidents? Let's lighten the mood now. 4 in-depth questions we had. So would you like to share with us?
The dialogue between me and my clients has never been formal. It's always dosti jaisa mahol rehta hai. So I was designing a bungalow outside Pune. I won't name the city, bapre wo samajh lega ki aaye kiske bare mein baat kar raha hu. nahi samjhega.
उन्होंने जालना थोड़ी बोला है।
Now you have clear है।
So that lady of the house came to me कि भैया मुझे ना suite room के जैसा bedroom चाहिए। मैं ला ठीक है। I have a bad habit of asking why to everything because then you understand why she is thinking like that. No, I like it that way. Why do you like it that way? I always wanted it like that. Why you always wanted it like that? So that the ultimate truth has to be revealed, you know? So she was giving me 10 different reasons for that. And somewhere something popped up in my mind. Does he snore? She said yes. So they wanted a sweet kind of a room.
Manish, do you have a funny incident or an anecdote to share with us?
Yeah, it is quite funny. I was designing a villa. It was a good size villa, around say 45,000 square feet built up area. 10 acres site, good view around. The client had gone to 7 architects before coming to me, approaching me. He had rejected 7 designs and my design was finalized later on. I shared a good bond with client later on. We became friends. The construction started. Almost 90% of construction was done. And one fine day, I got a call from the client. Manish bhai, site pe jate hain. Kuch urgent kaam hai. I said, okay, fine. So we went to the site. Once we went to the site, he showed me the perspective view. He showed me the site and he said, I should tell you about the design first before telling you this particular incident. The living room was around, say, 2,000 square feet with a good pyramidal roof over it, proper pyramid, maybe 50 by 50 square feet or whatever. The client said, I want to sit on that top of the pyramid and I want to enjoy my drink over there. I was stunned. I was like, boss, how is it possible? I thought he is out of his mind, but I shared a good bond. So I said, sir, let's think about it. It's not possible. It will ruin the design. He said, nahin, I want this. Aaj tak maine kuch bola nahi design ke bare mein. I have followed everything you have said. But this is the only wish I have in my mind, to sit on the top of the pyramid, enjoy the view around 360 degrees or 180 degrees, whatever view, whatever he has, and enjoy my drink. Well, that's the funniest, what you can say.
Very funny incident.
Baad mein kya hua? Okay, I'll share that also. I don't know. Okay. So, I was very particular. I said, it's not possible. It will ruin the design. And he was very adamant. He said, I want it. Aaj tak maine kuch bola nahi hai, but I want this. Ek mahina isme hi chala gaya. Construction was totally stopped. Activity on site. Finally, he called up. Are you going to do this? I said, no, sir. Then he said, okay, I'll do it on my own. Oh, I was frightened. I was scared. I said, I have done the 90% of work. And am I losing the project? I had to do it. And I provided something way out of the world, a sit out at the top of the pyramid. And he enjoyed that drink over there.
How do you approach it?
Approach and how you climb there.
We had to design a special ladder which can be hidden, and the ladder is still there, and he sometimes go to the top and
he does use it.
Yeah, he does use it.
Wow.
Good. I have a couple of experience like this, but a couple of years back, one landlord came to my office, okay, and I was doing his big flat, big size flat, okay, and he said, I want a big bathroom, okay, almost 300 square feet, that is a bathroom size, and I want to use, I think he don't know about the bathtub and jacuzzi, okay, so he said, you know, shit, you know, I've seen this, you know, bathtub in some, you know, film or something, you know, there. And I want to use, and I want to, you know, utilize the space as a jacuzzi. So, you know, we traveled some other place in India and we bought it, that jacuzzi. I mean, see, we have some technical specifications and everything we give him. And even, in fact, when we were there in the showroom that time, you know, we have a live demo, but not actual live. He was insisting me, I want to use that jacuzzi there only in the showroom. I was, my God, how come it's possible? You know, he was like, you know, like he had money. So he said, I want to use this and then only I'll buy it. I asked showroom guys, is it possible? Like, no, sir, this is not possible. So this kind of experience is like happened.
Amazing.
There are two incidents that I would like to mention here. One was when we were designing a villa, I think somewhere in Satara. I don't really recall. I think it was in Satara. So, the client being, you know, at some distance, we were sharing some things with him. So, on mail. So, initially we shared the plans and he wasn't satisfied with the plans. He was saying, okay, plan to ho gaya. Dikhne wala kaisa hai? Theek hai bhai, 3D karte hain iska bhi. हमको तो मालूम है लेकिन क्लाइंट को दिखाना है तो वी स्टार्टेड मेकिंग 3Ds एंड वी प्रेजेंटेड द 3Ds ही कम्स अप विद अ स्ट्रेंज रिप्लाई सेइंग ये मेरा घर नहीं है बस तेरा घर नहीं है मतलब वी हैव डिजाइंड इट फॉर यू एंड दिस इज व्हाट योर ब्रीफ वाज एंड अकॉर्डिंगली हमने दिया है नहीं लेकिन उसमें फोटो मेरा नहीं है सो व्हाट द हेल मैं तुमको फोटो भेजता हूँ वो जो 3D आपने भेजा है
उसपे मेरा मेरी बीवी का और मेरे बच्चों का फोटो आना चाहिए. Strange, you know, people have really very strange
affordable housing. A view is sent to him. बोलो ये विनोद मारुति कार क्यों लगाया? हाँ, 3D में. थोड़ा बड़ा Bentley लगो.
Okay, so the next question goes to Milin. Milin, honestly, what angers you or irritates you the most at work? One point which angers you or irritates you?
I'm not saying something just different or something just special things, but I'm a disciplined person. I want, when I visit the site and all, always I want the site with the clean and everything. Just.
So, at otherwise a, you don't like it if you're...
Yeah, always, always. If not, I fired or debited some amount for that contractor, everything. Always, always it happened. So, if I'm visiting next, after 2 days I'm visiting, the before that everybody's just
given. Okay, interesting. Abhi?
The most irritational part for me when I visit a site is many of times there are some POP structures or POP panning which is not in plumb line. Then some certain things which are not in right angle, which can be noticed by only the designers, not the client. That irritates me the more. A few days back, I was just showing one of my client that we are going to use this rose gold plate for the ceiling. We'll be making a profile in it, and wherever there is a right angle, there might be some dent. So the client said, "It's okay. The dent is only visible for me, not to the client." But still, I said that no, it will affect the aesthetics. So that I don't like.
That irritates you. Yeah. Vipin.
The uncalled intervention of someone other than client who is not related to him.
It happens that client has approved and some mama kaka from somewhere comes and says, ye peela karo ya, ye
nahi barabar nahi hai ye.
That irritates you the most. 100%. Absolutely. Atul?
Well, it's my workspace. My office boy has a habit of cleaning up the place every morning. And I like it to be left as it is, you know, the way I left it the day before. Because I know where I've kept my things. And he neatly organizes things. It's actually exactly opposite of what Milin said. He needs everything on site, spick and span. But that's something that I'm used to in my workspace. Site probably, yes, I agree to what he's saying. I need the site, you know, really clean when I'm going there and to find, you know, the right thing done in the right place. But my desk, I need it to be left as it is. And that is something that my office boy never listens to.
Manish?
Sometimes it happens that if I assign a design job to somebody in office, a junior designer or an architect, whatever, they are reluctant to come up with their own ideas. They rely more on social media like Pinterest or Instagram. And they come up with their concept as a photograph downloaded from the internet. And it's the most irritating thing for me. Because these are designers, these are architects, and not everybody. They have to come up with their own ideas, their own concepts. And I don't know, but that's the most irritating thing for me.
Ashish?
Yeah, actually, nothing irritates me. The moment something, you know, funny comes up, it's fun. Haste zor se, aur kuch nahi. So that irritation which is about to, you know, come up, dies down, and we continue. Nothing irritates me.
Vinod?
One thing irritates me is like, you know, the silly mistakes. We might do good jobs. A lot of efforts have gone, but there are certain very basic things which we neglect at the staff level, they neglect, and it becomes a big problem in later on. Maybe a north is wrong, maybe some dimensions are wrong, maybe the center line may mistake is there, and that is something which I fear, because a lot of time it has happened, you do a central, as Atul said rightly, ki site visit at center line and setting out is really very important. And somebody has gone on site and he's given a setting out wrong and the entire structure is built. So it's the most fearful thing is the silly mistakes. You might control everything, but silly mistake is something which is a very dangerous for the company.
True, true.
Yeah.
True that.
Yeah.
Sandeep?
For me, I can say selection part is a bit pain. No, actually, I'm very much interested in selection and all, but with the client, it's really pain.
It's the most painful thing.
Painful thing like selecting the veneers, selecting the tiles. It actually carries on for 2 to 3 days if the client is there. Especially
so
for the
you feel they should give a waste time.
It can be curtailed.
Anybody else doesn't have this problem and why? Who can help him solve this problem?
I will select the thing at my end only and you have to follow it.
But then you said in your first question that you don't.
I will match it to their if they want a walnut kind of a veneer, I'll make stain it out and I'll make it walnut. But I'll use only teak wood.
You should spend 5 minutes with him after that.
Actually, I'm just saying that it irritates me. Yeah. But I do manage that, definitely.
Nilesh?
I think same like Sandeep. Spending the whole day with them, selecting everything. Again, next day he'll call us, sir, maine wahan pe bhi acha dekha hai. Again, going for the same thing and spending one more day, it irritates us. That's the thing.
Vikas?
I irritated in my studio. Normally what happened, we have some standards as far as design is concerned. Okay, so we give them AutoCAD styles, templates, nameplates, measurements, policies and everything. And whenever the new people join, whether it's an experience or junior or whatever it is, we give them a 4 days ka training period. Okay, and the criteria for that 4 days training period only, we have to check our folder system or drawing system, whatever it is, whether it is 10 years experience architect or junior architect or 2 years experience architect. We don't, we have that 4 days is equal to everyone. And when actual work starts and when I want something as per my standard and these people are not giving me what I want, that irritates me a lot.
So inefficiency.
Inefficiency and negligence for a work.
Because I have a question for you, and this will go to everyone. Do you particularly dress as an architect or a designer in your profession, considering site visits or dressing for client meets or office work, or this doesn't matter?
No, I personally feel that you dressed up well. You need to have that sense of design, sense of dressing. That is very important. And you look presentable. That's what I feel. It doesn't matter. You have to have every time in blazer and all. But you look presentable. That is what I want.
Ashish?
Actually, the way I dress is an extension of me and my personality. I don't dress up for the event. It's like what I feel that day, I dress up.
So you don't consciously
I
should look like an architect when I go in front of a client, or I should.
No, rather I would ask you what is like looking like an architect. Lambe baal.
Exactly.
The
cliches.
Fab India ka. Yes, Shabnam. No, aisa kuch nahi hai.
Exactly. That was my point.
Aisa kuch bhi nahi hai. Us din jo man kiya aur jo ready hai, iron karke wo pehen liya.
Atul.
It's actually my comfort level that I think of when I'm dressing. So it's mainly formals on most of the days. And I make it a point to wear a jeans and a t-shirt on Saturdays and Sundays.
So perception of the client is important, you feel? You should be...
Well, it's my comfort more than the perception of the client. It's my comfort that I'm talking of. Okay. Yes, I do respect, when you are going for a meeting at a corporate office, you can't really dress up in jeans and a t-shirt. So I respect the clients.
What Ashish said, that probably, he doesn't give a thought where he is
probably
going.
Probably.
Again, as he said, being presentable is more important. Even I believe in that. Being presentable, whatever you are comfortable. And luckily, architects don't have a uniform. So it's the people's notion that architects look like that and whatever. But whatever I am comfortable in, at office and everywhere, the staff is... You wear anything, look good, be comfortable, and I think that is the thing. So I'll tell you when I go for juries for some colleges, the youngsters, I mean, they dress up like an architect. Like long kurtas, bade baal, dadi, chappals. You know, they don't look as if they have not taken a bath for a week. And when it comes to the design, it's all crap. There is no designer in it. Everything is that. So I call them, I call the teachers also, and I tell them, boss, it is, when he passes out, he'll be physically a designer, but mentally he will not be. So it's actually a wrong notion when people are following it to look like a designer. It's not.
Yeah, I personally feel that one should be well dressed because that builds the self confidence also in you while presenting yourself. The client also feels confident, feels confident about you that you are capable enough to handle my project. So one should be well dressed.
Vipin?
Yes, I do. I always dressed up for the work and I have a kind of flair for it. So always I dressed up for the occasion.
I'm sure you do have a flair for it, yeah.
It's a related question again. So I basically never do it consciously. I try to aptly dress on the particular occasion, but I feel more than the dressing, you should have that passion for it work first. Dressing comes afterwards. Yeah, but definitely, as he said, Vinod said, that personality also matters. So yeah, you have to do something. Like supposing some person is good looking, he doesn't need much to do. But if he's not good looking and he wants to look like, and he's a good architect, but if he wants to look like one, so he has to do some changes, okay. Definitely.
Okay. Milin?
Depend up. Always you should be just presentable. But it's depend upon today which client you are going to meet, which type of client basically. It's
or a site visit.
Yeah, on the site, a site visit or something. As per that, you should.
You feel yourself. It. Is yeah, right to do that. Nilesh?
I'm not pretty particular about it. I think I'm comfortable in casuals, so I go with that.
Okay. Manish?
Vikas rightly said that you should be presentable, and I feel that's the right way. You should be presentable. You should dress as per the event, whatever you are following. It shows, sometimes, it shows that you are serious about your work. And the people around you may follow the trend also. So it should be, I mean, you should be well-dressed.
Okay. Abhi, the next question goes to you. Has it ever happened in your career that you did not get due credit for your work, for your design, for a project which you did?
Such incident didn't happen in my life, but there are some projects which we worked very hard. I did my homework very well. Everything was good. We went for selections also, but that project didn't happen only.
So, of course, you felt the pain of that. Yeah, Vikas?
Yeah, it's happened with me. Sometimes what happened, the client is more, reliable on us and depending on us, for example. That time that he said, okay, you got a free hand and freedom and everything. And once it comes for the money or, that execution pass comes, that time he just backed out. So I have that couple of experience like this. And yes, I'm trying hard for that. In the next projects, I would not make any mistakes like this. So, this is my learning.
Candidly shared. You can avoid mentioning your clients if you wish. Vinod?
Yeah, I mean, there are various aspects. I mean, sometimes you're designing in a group of people. Sometimes you're designing at your office. The staffs are there. So at times, you're working for some clients. And there are a lot of time you feel that your design, you should get the credit, but at times it doesn't. You don't get it for it, and I think it is okay. I mean, it doesn't matter because koi takdeer chidke to jayega nahi. So
do you get disappointed when?
I don't get disappointed.
Honestly.
Yeah, honestly, because nothing goes waste. Somewhere or in some way, you are always paid. There are a lot of time it has happened when you have not got credit for certain things, but in due course, in some time, you really get paid according to maybe in terms of job or in terms of other things. So I don't think it does matter because giving credit is not in your hand. It is in somebody else's hand. I can control only myself. I cannot control the people around me.
True. Yeah. Very true. Milin?
It's never happened to me. Thank God it's never happened to me. Because the commercial terms and as a, when you start the project or before you're starting the project, if you're commercial, everything is clear and all. So I don't think it's happened with us, with anybody else.
Manish?
When you are young, it's quite possible that people exploit you and don't give you the credits. But it's long back for me.
But such an incident happened.
Yeah, it happened. But I like to share the current incident. After practicing for more than 20 years now, whenever we finish a site, we do the photography. We get the professional photographer and get the photography done. And when we show it to the client, it's on a lighter note, I'm telling you. Sometimes the client says, wow, photo mein kitna achha dikhta hai. As if it's not in real. So the credit goes to the photographer, not to the architect.
Ashish?
Actually, it doesn't happen with me. Only once, ek bar hua hai. There was a huge, huge industrial tycoon. For him, we designed a farmhouse near Pune. And he was on the show, Walk the Talk. Where NDTV pe aata tha. To, arre yaar, apna client hai. Aa raha hai. To, I was hooked onto the channel. Then they, Bombay mein baithe. चॉपर से आए और लैंड किया साइट पे. वाह, अपना फार्म हाउस दिखा रहे हैं. अभी कुछ ना कुछ तो बोलना चाहिए अपने बारे में. कुछ ना कुछ तो छोड़ दो. जब एंकर ने उसको पूछा, यू डिड ऑल दिस बाय योरसेल्फ, ही सेड यस यस यस, सब मैंने किया.
संदीप?
या इट वाज लॉन्ग टाइम बैक एक्चुअली. वी इनिशियली व्हेन वी स्टार्टेड आवर स्टूडियो, इट्स वे बैक इन 1995. I was doing a small flat, you know, like for 400 square feet. And he had a big terrace of 900 square feet. So he was my friend actually. We were doing a site for him. We designed all the flat and I was landscaping that time. We were landscaping it. We did all the civil part and all, everything. Designing was done by us. And we wanted somebody to take care of the waterfall, the plantation and all. So I was looking for persons. I got many people, but I was not satisfied. So one light supplier of me told me he's got one person. I won't take his name now, and I hooked him actually. He was not ready to come. He said, I don't do such small sites. I said, you come once, visit, if you like it, we'll go ahead. And he liked it, and then he was very enthusiastic. He did everything, and one fine day, my client calls me and says, boss, that fellow who has done plantation and all, he's come here, he's photographing your site. So it's okay, I said. We were very new that time. But he said, he says that this is going to come in a magazine. And eventually, I don't know how to say, the first photograph which came of landscape, it was in Indian Digest, and the name was his actually. I didn't mind that, but after a long time, I got to know that this will have done like this. So it happens, but we moved on. It's okay.
So very sad, very sad. Because plagiarism is a very...
Yeah, but it happens. Actually, it happens in our fraternity also. So it's very true, but we have to deal with it. You have to move
ahead. Honesty should be there. Transparency should be there.
It depends on the person. It depends on the person.
Giving the credit is absolutely...
He mentioned
I've seen many designers who mention their contractors.
No, actually, Amit, let me tell you. He mentioned our name in a very different manner. That too because my client poked him actually. So it happens.
Atul?
Well, there have been both type of experiences. There have been clients coming up and appreciating your work. So you really, you know, get all your due. But at times there have also been, in monetary terms, yes, a lot of, even after these 25 years of practicing and doing things, I think I haven't learned as yet. You just keep trusting people. I think I need to approach Milind in this case. I noticed his answer. So some after this probably.
We are coming to a final question now. Ashish, any particular film dialogue or a famous quote or a famous line which has stayed in your mind?
Actually, it's not a film or a line, it's a song. It goes like this. Main har ek pal ka shayar hoon. Har ek pal meri kahani hai. Har ek pal meri hasti hai.
हर एक पल मेरी जवानी है.
वाह वाह. I would love this song on this. So I would love to correct and you sing it again. It's मैं पल दो पल का शायर हूँ. Acha, this is your this.
No. See, that is the irony of it. Oh. Now don't edit this. What I'm telling you right now. See, there's a movie called Kabhi Kabhi. There's one positive song and there's one negative song. Okay. Irony क्या है? Negativity को ज़्यादा famous होती है negativity. When you hear पल दो पल का शायर हूँ, मैं पल दो पल का शायर हूँ, पल दो पल मेरी जवानी है, कल और आएंगे नगमों की गलती गिलियाँ चुनने वाले, मुझसे बेहतर करने वाले, तुमसे बेहतर सुनने वाले, इट्स ऑल अबाउट नेगेटिविटी. इन द सेम मूवी इज अ पॉजिटिव सॉन्ग. मैं हर एक पल का शायर हूँ, हर एक पल मेरी कहानी है, हर एक पल मेरी हस्ती है, हर एक पल मेरी जवानी है. सम अदर टाइम आई विल एक्सप्लेन यू टिल द एंड.
दिस इज एन एजुकेशन फॉर मी. अमेजिंग स्टार्ट टू दिस राउंड. अमेजिंग.
सी दिस एंटायर सॉन्ग मेरे केबिन में लगा हुआ
है. आई नो, आई हैव सीन इट ऑन द ग्लास.
हां, और पल दो पल का शायर जो सॉन्ग है ना, रिसेप्शन पे लगा हुआ है. ओके. ईच स्टैंजा ऑफ दिस सॉन्ग एक्सप्लेन्स द वे आई डू माई प्रैक्टिस. टू एंड इट, दैट सॉन्ग वो एंड ऐसा होता है, तू अपनी अदाएं बख्श इन्हें, मैं अपनी वफाएं देता हूँ. क्लाइंट एंड आर्किटेक्ट. तू अपनी अदाएं बख्श इन्हें, मैं अपनी वफाएं देता हूँ, जो अपने लिए सोची थी कभी वो सारी दुआएं देता हूँ.
एक्सलेंट. अभी
some few things. Firstly it is in Marathi. वेळ गेल्यावर वेळेचं महत्व कळतं. Secondly, one of my godfather used to tell me, अभिजीत पैसा भगवान नहीं है. अभिजीत पैसा भगवान नहीं है, लेकिन भगवान से कम भी नहीं है. And I would love to say one quote, that life is a learning process.
Great. Thanks for sharing. Atul?
There are a lot of them. But just on a lighter note, there is this beautiful song from a Devanand film. Ek ghar banaunga tere ghar ke saamne, duniya basaunga tere ghar ke saamne, ek ghar banaunga tere ghar ke saamne. So in this movie, Devanand has been shown as an architect.
Nilesh?
You want a filmy dialogue, so I'll go with this Hiropanti dialogue. Tiger Shroff, okay? He was asked, kya re Hiropanti karega? And he says, kya karu, sabko aati nahi, meri jaati nahi. So that touches me, you know.
Sandeep? Okay. Vinod?
I start with a quote. It's like, thoughts manifest the destination. Thoughts manifest the destination. Whatever you think, it's a secret of success. So it's taken rightly in a movie. Shah Rukh Khan says, "Itni shiddat se tumhe paane ki maine koshish ki, har zarre ne tumse milane ki saajish ki." So whatever, कोई भी चीज़ को अगर आप दिल से चाहते हो तो सारी कायनात उसको मिलाने की आपकी कोशिश करो. So it's like it's a formula or the mantra for success. Keep thinking positive and things go right for you.
Superb. Manish,
the quote which I like or which I admire the most is, less is more. I'm totally into architecture. Less is more by Ludwig Mies van der Rohe. It explains so many things in such a short sentence.
Well said, Manish. Vipin?
My favorite film dialogue is from Trishul. And my favorite actor, Mr. Amitabh Bachchan, is done by. Sahi baat sahi waqt pe kiya jaye, to uska maza hi kuch aur hai. Sahi baat sahi waqt pe kiya jaye, to uska maza hi kuch aur hai. Aur main sahi waqt ka intezaar karta hoon.
Wonderful.
Wonderful. Somebody has asked me, who's your mentor? Okay, so I said, my experience is my mentor. And Mr. Amit Danath had asked me this question. So my overall experience is my mentor. So I would like to give you two lines of my what I feel every day. I just, you know, remembering those. First is like, aane wala pal jaane wala hai. So this is why I always remember this, ki jo bhi waqt aane wala hai abhi, wo jaane wala hi hai. And be with the present, live in the present. Like. And second is, koshish karne walo ki kabhi haar nahi hoti.
Kya baat? Milind.
Aane wala pal jaane wala hai. Aane wala pal jaane wala hai. Ho sake to isme zindagi bita do. Pal jo ye jaane wala hai. Ho.
Amazing session, amazing episode. Thank you so much, everyone, for coming forth, being so honest, candid, sharing your innermost thoughts, feelings, strengths, weaknesses, so candidly. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Stereo stylus in this groove.